10 insane facts about the history of Thanksgiving. Thanksgiving has become a time for most of us to express our appreciation for the abundance in our lives, whether it's the strong relationships we have with our friends and families, or opportunities, or our health, and of course, to gorge ourselves on mashed potatoes. However, the holiday's origins are more complicated than simply a reminder of the appreciation we should express every day of the year. Thanksgiving, as it happens, has several aspects, including spectacle, entrepreneurial spirit, economic recovery, and of course, food. Thanksgiving may be the most popular national holiday in the United States, but its history is a jumbled mess. Even the details of the memorable feast in November 1621 between the Plymouth Colony settlers and the Wampanoag Indians are hazy. The finest description we have is from an English settler named Edward Winslow, who describes a week-long harvest festival that featured a three-day celebration with King Massasoit and 90 Wampanoag men, so that we might, after a more special manner, rejoice together. Hi guys, welcome back to Astonishing Top 10, and in today's video I will tell you about the 10 insane facts about the history of Thanksgiving. However, before we go any further, make sure you subscribe to this channel and don't forget to hit that bell icon so that you never miss any updates. Now, without further ado, let's get into this. At number 10, we have a woman named Sarah Josepha Hale lobbied Congress for years to make Thanksgiving an official holiday. Thanksgiving would not exist today if it were not for this determined woman. Sarah Josepha Hale spent years lobbying Congress to make Thanksgiving an official holiday. Thanksgiving has been a source of national pride for Hale since 1827, and she sought to make it permanently an American custom and institution. President Abraham Lincoln did not proclaim Thanksgiving a national holiday until 1863. Given that the president did this during the Civil War, some view Thanksgiving to be an attempt by the president to restore peace to the country. Number 9. Originally, Thanksgiving may not have been celebrated in November at all, but rather mid-October. Yes, you heard that right. Thanksgiving may not have been observed in November at all, but rather in mid-October in the past. On the exact date of the first Thanksgiving, there is no clear historical evidence. The holiday was set to fall on the final Thursday in November by President Abraham Lincoln, probably to commemorate the initial landing of the Pilgrims in New England on the Mayflower. Number 8. In 1939, President Franklin D. Roosevelt changed the date of Thanksgiving to 1 week earlier. Yes, Thanksgiving was moved 1 week earlier in 1939 by President Franklin D. Roosevelt. Roosevelt hoped that by extending the holiday shopping season, he would be able to boost spending and alleviate the depression. Some states refused to acknowledge the move, resulting in 2 years of inconsistent Thanksgiving Day ceremonies. By 1941, FDR had caved in and signed a bill designating the fourth Thursday in November as the official date for Thanksgiving across the country, regardless of whether it was the month's last Thursday or not. Number 7. Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade in 1924. The Central Park Zoo provided live animals for the first Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade in 1924. Despite the fact that the parade was only 2 blocks long, New York City went all out for what tabloids dubbed a marathon of mirth. There was, however, none of the balloons that the parade is now known for. Instead, the Central Park Zoo provided live bears, elephants, camels, and monkeys, floats with puppets, celebrities, bands, costumed Macy's staff, and of course, Santa Claus were also on display. Number 6. Thanksgiving leftovers led to the first ever TV dinner. Swanson Foods miscalculated the amount of turkey that would be consumed on Thanksgiving in 1953 and had to come up with imaginative ways to use the 260 tons of surplus flesh. They made a Thanksgiving-inspired meal with the aforementioned turkey, cornbread, dressing, gravy, peas, and sweet potatoes, using 5,000 aluminum trays and a hand-packing line. The dish was sold for a total of 98 cents, and 10 million were sold in the first full year of manufacturing, launching the packed frozen meal industry. Number 8. Benjamin Franklin was very pro-turkey. Benjamin Franklin was a strong supporter of turkey, however, not in the way you might expect. It was not so much because he loved the animal's attributes, as it was that he felt the bird was delectable. Franklin, rather than the bald eagle, thought the turkey should be the official bird of the United States. He once wrote, "I wish the bald eagle had not been chosen as our country's representative. His is a bird of low moral character." Franklin, it appears, thought the turkey was a far more honorable bird. Number 4. Menu for the first Thanksgiving. Lobster, seals, and swans were most likely on the table for the first Thanksgiving in Plymouth in 1621. No, turkey did not show up for the first Thanksgiving, which took place in 1621. The feast between the Pilgrims and the Wampanoag Native Americans lasted 3 days and included contributions from both groups. Though the exact meal is unknown, it is known that the Pilgrims hunted for local poultry, including swans, and that the Wampanoag brought 5 deer. Due to the abundance of lobster and seal in the vicinity, it is suspected that they were implicated. Number 3. Pumpkin Pie Love. Although it is not America's favorite pie, pumpkin pie has been popular for a long time. People have been making pumpkin pies since the mid-1600s, according to records. Pumpkins were most certainly present for the first Thanksgiving, though not in pie form. Since the 1700s, the dessert has been a staple of Thanksgiving dinners. In fact, in 1705, a molasses scarcity forced several Connecticut towns to postpone the festival due to a lack of molasses, which prevented people from preparing pies. The American Pie Council, on the other hand, is putting a stop to the pumpkin versus apple pie controversy. According to their findings, apple pies are the most popular in America, with pumpkin pies following in second. Number 2. Thanksgiving Football Games. Football games on Thanksgiving Day have been going on since the 1870s. Football on Thanksgiving Day began long before the country had access to television. When the Thanksgiving game tradition began, football was not even a professional sport. Yale took on Princeton in the first ever Thanksgiving Day football game in 1876. The sport was still evolving at that time, from a rugby hybrid to the game we know today. For nearly 15 years, games were only played at the college and high school level. When the National Football League was created in 1920, it eventually began scheduling as many as 6 Thanksgiving games each year. Number 1. Dark Side of Thanksgiving. The history of Thanksgiving Day has a very dark side to it. While we celebrate all that we have and all that this place has to offer, it is vital to remember that millions of Native Americans died as a result of European settlement, and that life for indigenous peoples was forever altered by the coming of the English. Many people observe the last Thursday in November as a national day of mourning. Consider pausing this Thanksgiving to think on how the stories we received as children were not always realistic depictions of how we came to call this country home. That's all for today's video, and thanks for watching it. If you liked it, make sure to give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. Also, don't forget to share your thoughts and valuable feedback with us in the comments section below. Lastly, if you have not already subscribed to this channel, subscribe to it and press that bell icon so that you will be notified each time we upload an interesting video on this channel. And while you are here, click to watch one of these 2 videos that are appearing on your screen. We will see you there. Take care and stay tuned.